There are four identical containers kept on weighing machines. In each of them, same amount of water is filled. In the B part, a lead ball is immersed in the water. As the density of lead is greater than the density of water, a string is attached at the top of the ball and the other end of the string is attached on a rigid support. In the C and D, table tennis balls are immersed in the water, and as the density of table tennis balls is lesser than that of water, to keep them immersed in this position, strings are attached from bottom of the ball to the rigid support. In part C, as you can see, there is a rigid rod of the shape L that I have shown with black color, and the red color is the string. In the D part, the string is attached, one end of the string is attached at the bottom of the ball and the other end of the string is attached at the bottom of the container. We have to compare the weights read by the weighing machines. The volume of all the three balls is the same. First, let us see how much is the buoyant force acting on the balls due to the surrounding fluid, due to the surrounding water. Let us say that rho is the density of the water. So rho. V is the volume of all the three balls. V. The buoyant force acting on all of them will be the same. It will be in the upward direction. Why same? Because as the volume of all of them is same, they will displace the same amount of water. And by Archimedes' principle, the buoyant force acting on them will be equal to the weight of the water displaced by them. How much will be that weight? It will be rho vg. So the buoyant force acting on all of them will be Fb is equal to rho vg. Okay. Since the amount of water in all four of them is the same, let us say that m is the mass of the water. M. Okay. Let us say that the weights read by the weighing machine is in newtons. How much will be the force acting in the downward direction in part A? It will be mg. So the weighing machine A will read weight WA is equal to mg. Let us come to the part B. The buoyant force acting upwards is Fb. Due to the tension in the string, the T force will act on the lead ball in the upward direction. Let us say that M1 is the mass of this ball. So the gravitational force that is going to act in the downward direction, it will be M1g. As this lead ball is in equilibrium, we can write down the equation for B part. T plus Fb is equal to M1g. How much is the force acting on the weighing machine? Again, the force due to the water is mg. And one more force will act on the weighing machine. It will be the buoyant force in the downward direction. How? The surrounding fluid is pushing the lead ball in the upward direction. The buoyant force is Fb. And by Newton's third law of motion, the ball will give the same reaction Fb on the water in the downward direction. So the weight read by the weighing machine B will be Wb is equal to mg plus Fb. Let's come to the part C. The buoyant force in the upward direction is Fb. Let us say that M2 is the mass of the table tennis ball. So the gravitational force acting on this ball in the downward direction is M2g. The tension in the string will pull the ball in the downward direction with force T. And as the table tennis ball is also in equilibrium, we can write T plus M2g is equal to Fb. how much is the force acting on the bottom of the container or on the weighing machine. It will be again mg due to the water, and the reaction of FB will act in the downward direction FB. So the weight read by the weighing machine C will be equal to WC is equal to mg plus FB. Come to the part D. Again, the buoyant force acting in the upward direction will be the same, FB. That will be equal to rho VG. As we have said that M2 is the mass of the table tennis ball, so the gravitational force acting in the downward direction will be M2G, and the tension in the string will pull it in the downward direction with the force T. So as again this ball is in equilibrium, we can write FB is equal to M2G plus T. Let us take T on one side, so T is equal to FB minus M2G. How much will be the force acting on the weighing machine? It will be equal to mg due to the mass of the surrounding water. The reaction of FB that will act on the weighing machine, FB, and the tension in the string will now pull the weighing machine or apply force on the bottom of the container, rather in the upward direction. So the weight read by the weighing machine D will be WD is equal to mg plus FB minus T. Let us substitute the value of T from the above equation. So WD is equal to mg plus FB minus FB plus m2g. FB and FB will get cancelled. WD will be equal to mg plus m2g. Now the buoyant force FB was equal to rho VG. And let us say that sigma is the density of the table tennis ball. So m2g can be written as sigma into V into g. And as the density of the table tennis ball is lesser than the density of water, m2g will be less than FB. So as m2g is less than FB, we can say that WD will be less than WB and WC. So we can write down WB is equal to WC because they are reading the same weight. They both are greater than WD, and WD is further greater than WA.